If you are into human optimization and longevity as much as we are, you have for sure heard about intermittent fasting. But what happens in your body when you fast? Does it really help your longevity? And most importantly, should you actually do it? Join us in today's video where we will dive into how intermittent fasting affects your mitochondrial health and longevity. I am Alessandro Carpentiero.
And I am Linda Grönfors. We at Beyond Sapiens help you maximize your human potential by optimizing your mind, body, and work.
Intermittent fasting, IF for short, is scientifically referred to as time-restricted feeding, or TRF. And simply put, it's all about reducing your eating window, aka the time when you eat, so that your body can reap the benefits of a fasted state. This eating pattern has been practiced for centuries, actually if you think about it, millennia, given that our ancestors had to hunt and gather to get food. Now, well, things are quite different. If you look at a standard eating schedule for most people, breakfast is between 6 and 7 a.m., while the last meal of the day might finish at 7 or 8 p.m., or even later if you consider pre-bed snacks. So on average, you might have a feeding window of around 14 hours and a fasting window of 10. Ideally, you should consider flipping the script to have at least 14 hours of fasting and 10 hours of feeding. But why should you do it? Before giving you any tips, I would just like to remind you to consult with your healthcare provider before you embark on any significant changes to your nutrition. And if you need help with that, we can actually help with our ultra-customized nutrition plans based on your gut microbiome and genome sequencing. Now, getting back to fasting, there's a lot of emerging research on the potential benefits of TRF. And one area of particular interest is how intermittent fasting impacts mitochondrial optimization. Mitochondria are the powerhouses of our cells, responsible for producing the energy our body needs, ATP. When your mitochondria function optimally, can have a profound impact on your overall health and longevity. You can do many things to optimize your mitochondrial health. For example, in last week's video, and by the way, thank you so much for all the views, we explored how zone 2 and VO2 max cardio can help with that. But research shows that intermittent fasting can also help. During fasting periods, our cells experience a state of mild stress, triggering beneficial adaptations, including increased production of antioxidants, enhanced DNA repair, activation of autophagy, and reduced inflammation. All these changes can have a positive impact on your mitochondria, helping them function at their best. But why should you care about optimizing your mitochondrial function? Well, there's a lot at stake here, given that it improves cellular energy production, metabolic flexibility, efficient nutrient utilization, and overall cellular health. These effects may contribute to increased resilience against age-related diseases and potentially even longevity benefits. And that's where autophagy comes into play.
Indeed. Autophagy, derived from Greek roots meaning self-eating, is a fascinating process that serves as a vital mechanism for rejuvenating your mitochondria during fasting. It involves breaking down and recycling old, damaged, or dysfunctional cells and cellular structures, including mitochondria, in order to clear out compromised components and make way for the growth of new, healthy mitochondria. Think of it as a spring cleaning for your cells, ensuring that only the healthiest cells and mitochondria remain active. But how does autophagy work its magic? It all starts with the nutrient deprivation during fasting. When your body senses the scarcity of energy from food, it activates autophagy as a survival mechanism to save energy. Damaged or no longer needed cellular components are tagged for removal. This breakdown promotes the creation of new and healthy cellular structures. By activating autophagy, you not only clear out dysfunctional mitochondria, but also improve the quality of the remaining ones. This process enhances your cellular efficiency, boosts energy production, and supports overall mitochondrial health. It plays a crucial role in cellular renewal, maintaining the integrity of cellular functions and preventing the accumulation of harmful substances within the cells. Autophagy also acts as a cellular stress response mechanism, helping cells adapt to stressors and protect themselves from damaging factors such as oxidative stress, inflammation, and the accumulation of toxic proteins. Furthermore, it has been linked to anti-aging effects, as the decline in autophagic activity is associated with aging and age-related diseases. By promoting cellular rejuvenation and removing damaged components, autophagy may help slow the aging process and extend a healthy lifespan. However, it's essential to strike a balance and ensure proper nutrient replenishment. Extended periods of autophagy without adequate nutrient intake can lead to nutrient deficiency, muscle wasting, and other adverse effects. Therefore, maintaining a balanced and personalized approach to fasting is essential. After breaking your fast, it's crucial to provide your body with sufficient nutrients to fully benefit from autophagy without compromising overall health and cellular structures.
To fully understand the benefits of intermittent fasting, it's essential to look at its hormonal and metabolic effects on our bodies and how they impact mitochondrial function. However, before we go deeper, I have a side note for our female viewers. Most research on time-restricted feeding, in fact, has not focused on its implications on female hormonal balance. So considering how complex and fascinating female hormones are, adjusting the fasting protocol accordingly is important. And in the next segment, Linda will share with you practical strategies specifically addressing this aspect. That said, three key hormones play significant roles when fasting: insulin, human growth hormone, also known as HGH, and cortisol. Insulin is a hormone responsible for regulating blood sugar levels, and intermittent fasting positively influences insulin sensitivity, meaning that it helps your cells respond more effectively to insulin. This allows your body to efficiently utilize and store glucose, leading to better control of blood sugar levels and improved mitochondrial function. In simpler terms, intermittent fasting helps your body use insulin more efficiently, resulting in a more balanced and optimized energy management system. This can help prevent the development of insulin resistance, a condition where cells become less responsive to insulin and may lead over the long term to develop even type 2 diabetes. Next, human growth hormone, essential for growth, maintenance of bone and muscle mass, and other crucial functions, is impacted by intermittent fasting. As we get older, HGH levels naturally decline, leading to age-related issues such as decreased muscle strength and increased body fat. Intermittent fasting has been found to stimulate the production of human growth hormone, especially during longer fasting periods. This can help combat age-related declines in bone density and muscle mass, and even promote muscle gain when combined with strength training. These effects contribute to overall health and optimization of your mitochondria. Lastly, cortisol, commonly referred to as the stress hormone, can also be influenced by intermittent fasting, and especially prolonged fasting periods may lead to increased cortisol levels, which are associated with fat storage. However, it's important to note that the overall effects of intermittent fasting on cortisol are complex and highly individual. So while elevated cortisol levels can have negative implications, the absence of glucose during fasting periods forces the body to rely on stored fat as energy, mitigating the potential fat retention effects of cortisol. Since I started intermittent fasting 1 year ago, I have noticed positive effects on how my body stores fat. But in particularly stressful periods, I found myself waking up like at 4 a.m. fully alert, and that is something usually correlated with elevated cortisol levels. That's why the most important thing is to always personalize your approach to your current lifestyle, and in the next segment, we'll give you practical tips on how to do just that.
Incorporating intermittent fasting into your daily routine can be a seamless process with the right strategies. To ensure a smooth transition and allow your body enough time to adapt, it's advisable to start gradually. Fasting can impose stress on your body as it affects your cortisol levels, so managing chronic stress is essential before starting intermittent fasting. I personally made the mistake of beginning fasting during a high stress period, which had negative consequences. However, it worked like magic once I reduced my stress levels and found the perfect way to implement fasting. When you're ready, begin with a 12-hour fasting window overnight, followed by a 12-hour eating window during the day. Gradually extend the fasting period until you find the duration that suits you best, usually between 12 to 18 hours. I find that fasting for 14 hours with a 10-hour eating window works well for my current lifestyle and stress levels. Pay close attention to your body's signals and make adjustments accordingly. Proper hydration is also crucial during the fasting period. Drink enough water, herbal tea, or infused water to support your body's natural detoxification processes and overall well-being. It's common to experience headaches due to lack of electrolytes during fasting, so consider adding more electrolytes if you encounter this issue. When it's time to break your fast, focus on consuming balanced, nutrient-dense meals to help your body refuel. It may be challenging to obtain all macronutrients within a smaller eating window. Still, it's crucial to balance your caloric intake of macronutrients during this time to maintain bodily functions and reap the benefits of intermittent fasting. Include a wide variety of whole foods, such as lean proteins, healthy fats, fruits, vegetables, and whole grains to promote mitochondrial health and overall vitality. Throughout the day, pay attention to your body's signals. Intermittent fasting is not a one-size-fits-all approach, and it's crucial to notice how your body responds and adjusts to your fasting routine. If you experience any negative effects or prolonged discomfort, consult a healthcare professional and consider extending your eating window to give your body more fueling time. Remember, individual variation exists, so listen to your body, monitor your biomarkers, and potentially consult with a professional to determine the most suitable fasting and eating schedule for you.
We hope this video gave you a clear overview of how intermittent fasting can supercharge your mitochondrial health. Of course, when you eat is just half of the equation. What you eat is also vital, especially because we are all different and what works perfectly for me might not work for you. That's why with our Beyond Sapiens coaching, you can have access to the last frontier of human optimization, where we use state-of-the-art precision medicine testing to create a plan perfectly tailored for you. When it comes to nutrition, in fact, we test, for example, your gut microbiome and sequence your DNA to discover predispositions related to diet, metabolism, organ function, and overall health. And then our nutritional biologist uses all that to develop a precision plan to make you thrive. This has helped me so much, and that's why I'm so passionate about sharing all this with you too. If you want to learn more about how to start your Beyond Sapiens journey, just visit our website beyondsapiens.co or book a call with Linda and me from the link in the description. We're looking forward to helping you evolve your human potential.
And if you want to gain innovative ideas and solutions to maximize your mind, body, and work, please subscribe to our channel so that you don't miss our weekly science-based videos. Thanks for watching, and we will see you next week.